Welcome. In this video, we're going to show you how to create a custom photo note card in Photoshop Elements that you can print on Red River's line of pre-scored inkjet note cards. This tutorial is for Mac users with Photoshop Elements 6 and higher. Some of your screens may look slightly different, but the workflow and steps will be the same. First, you can download blank card templates from our website. Go to redriverpaper.com/templates. Click on the link and download the template zip file to your hard drive. Once the zip file is on your computer, you'll need to unzip it to see the contents. Double-click on the file. Once extracted, you'll have the templates in a folder. Double-click on the folder to view its contents. Templates with the word land will create cards that open vertically. Templates with the word vert are used for cards that open like a book. When you've selected and opened a template, you'll see this note with some helpful reminders. Begin by locating the Layers palette. If you do not see it, go to the Windows menu and select Layers. Now click on the eye to turn this layer off. The blue guides around the edge of the template represent the printable area and margins of most inkjet printers. The middle guide represents where your card will fold. If you have a version of Photoshop Elements that does not show these guides, you can use the grid feature to help line up the elements of your card. Go to the View menu and select Grid. Now it's time to open your image. Go to the File menu and select Open. Choose an image for your card. Now you'll resize the photo to fit properly on the card. A sizing guide is available in the written layout instructions on our website. In this case, I'm setting up for a 7x10 card size, and I want to have a 4x6 photo. So click on the Crop tool and change the dimensions in this area of the screen to the size that you want. Now I can crop the photo. Now put your photo and layout next to each other on the screen. Activate the Move tool. You can also hit V on your keyboard. Click and hold the mouse button and drag the photo onto your layout like this. The photo now becomes a new layer on your layout. You can move this layer around either with the Move tool or the arrow keys on your keyboard. Place the photo where you'd like it on the layout. In this case, I put it in the middle of the printable area. At this point, I could simply make a print, but I'd like to add some text to the back of the card. So choose the Text tool or click T on your keyboard. You'll choose the font and font size in this area of the screen. And now you can type a message. The text will be a new layer on your layers palette. It can be moved around freely on the layer using the Move tool. So we'll choose the Move tool again or hit V on your keyboard. Drag the text where you'd like it on the layout. Fine adjustments can be made using the arrow keys on your keyboard. Your layout is now complete. Here's the front outside of your card and the back outside of your card. You can now proceed to the print process. Begin by going to the File menu and choose Print. First, you'll select your printer from this drop-down menu, and now we'll go to Page Setup. You'll format for the printer that you're using. And under the Paper Size drop-down, you'll go to Manage Custom Sizes. Here we'll define the paper size and start by clicking the plus button In the width, you'll set it to the smallest dimension of the paper you're using, and in height will always be the longest dimension of the paper you're using. In this case, it's 7x10. Under margins, this is important on a Mac, set the margins to no less than 0.15 inches on all four sides. Now you can name the paper that you just created, and you can click OK. Now click OK again, and this brings you back to the preview, and under Select Print Size, you have to choose Actual Size. Now the preview looks accurate. Now click Print. In the Print dialog, you'll hit this drop-down menu and choose Quality and Media. First, you'll set your media type, and this is based on the type of paper that you're using. Under Print Quality, set that to your desired setting. And now you can click Print, confident you'll get a great-looking custom photo note card.